Welcome students. Elasticity of demand. Introduction. The most powerful tools of economics for analyzing the way market forces determine price and production in a competitive market are demand and supply analysis. Before embarking into the learning of theory of elasticity of demand, one needs to have a clear understanding of demand and its determinants. Demand. The term demand reflects consumer behavior. It shows how much a consumer is willing to buy at a given income, price and time. A mere want is not demand in economics. It can be defined as, it is the amount of goods and services consumers are willing and able to buy at a given period of time. Determinants of demand. Demand is affected by many variables, but according to economists, the six principal variables that influence the quantity demanded of a good or services are price of a good or service, income of consumers, price of related goods and services, taste and preference of consumers, future expected prices of goods and services, and the number of consumers in the market. Demand functions, generalized demand functions. The relation between quantity demanded and the above mentioned six affecting factors is referred to as generalized demand functions. It shows how all the six variables jointly determine the quantity demanded. In order to discuss the individual effect of any one of the six variables has on the quantity demanded, we can change just that variable and explain its influence on demand, keeping all other factors constant. Ordinary demand function. Traditionally, economists have referred to ordinary demand function as simply demand function. It shows the relation between the quantity demanded and the price of the product when all other variables affecting demand are held constant at specific values. This function is derived from the generalized demand function. Thus, a demand function expresses the quantity demanded as a function of price of the product only, holding constant the effect of income, consumer taste, price of related goods, number of consumers, and expected prices. Demand schedule. Demand schedule is a table showing the list of possible product prices and corresponding quantities demanded. A hypothetical table is shown in the visual. Demand curve. A demand curve is a graph showing relation between quantity demanded and price when all other factors variable influencing price are held constant. A demand curve is highly influenced by consumer behavior. A hypothetical demand curve is shown in the visual. Law of demand. Law of demand presents the functional relationship between price and quantity demanded. The statement of law is as follows. The quantity demanded increases when price falls and quantity demanded decreases when price rises, other things remaining constant. Thus, price and quantity demanded are inversely related, keeping other affecting variables constant. Explanation. The inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded can be explained by two effects. Substitution effect and income effect. Substitution effect. Suppose when price of a particular good rises, the consumer finds its substitute comparatively cheaper and so they shift their demand to the substitute goods, which leads to the decrease in the demand of the original good. Income effect. With the rise in price of goods or services, keeping money income constant, the consumer's real income decreases, that is, their purchasing power decreases. Thus, this leads to the decrease in quantity demanded. Change in demand. Demand can change because of any of the six influencing factors. Accordingly, these changes can be categorized into two types: change in quantity demanded and change in demand or shift in demand. Change in quantity demanded. When demand changes because of change in price, keeping other variables constant, it is termed as change in quantity demanded. Here, the demand moves along the same curve. With the increase in price, when quantity demanded decreases, the point on the demand curve moves upward and it is termed as contraction of demand. Similarly, with the decrease in price, when quantity demanded increases, the point reflecting demand on the curve moves downward, which is termed as expansion of demand. Change in demand. Keeping price constant, when demand changes due to other variables, that is income, taste and preference, etc., it is termed as change in demand. Here, at the same price, due to change in any of the five factors, the demand too changes, and one can see that the whole demand curve shifts either towards left or right. Leftward shift is termed as decrease in demand and rightward shift as increase in demand. Elasticity of demand. Introduction. By now we have been introduced to demand and factors affecting it. But for a businessman, it is not enough to know that demand for a product decreases with the increase in price or decrease in income. As a person in marketplace making real price decision, the business person needs to know the quantitative impact of price change on quantity demanded. Thus, in the most real world situation, economist and business analyst cannot just get away by saying, if we raise our price, our sales will fall, or if income rises this quarter, then our demand will increase. The question that needs to be answered is, by how much? To measure this, we use the concept elasticity. Elasticity is the measure of responsiveness of one variable to the change in another. Demand elasticity. Demand elasticity is the measure of responsiveness or sensitivity to quantity demanded to the change in its determinants. Thus, it measures the effect of a change in any factor affecting demand on the total consumption expenditure on a product. Mathematically, demand elasticity can be presented as shown in the visual. Not only managers of private firms, but decision makers within the government have to have an idea of how responsive people in the real world will be with the change in price. The concept of demand elasticity provides managers, economists and policy makers with a framework of understanding why consumers in some market are extremely responsive to the change in price and other determinants of demand, while it is not so in the other markets. Types of demand elasticity. Economists have identified three main types of demand elasticity. They are price elasticity of demand, income elasticity of demand, cross elasticity of demand. Price elasticity of demand. Price is one of the important determinant of demand that affects the quantity demanded. Price elasticity of demand measures the relationship between price and quantity demanded for a particular commodity. Price elasticity of demand is defined as a measure of the responsiveness of demand to the change in price. Thus, price elasticity of demand shows the relative amount by which the quantity demanded will change in response to the change in price of a particular commodity. Price elasticity of demand is represented by ED and the formula is as shown in the visual. The negative sign. According to the theory of demand, price and quantity demanded are inversely related to each other, and so the coefficient of price elasticity of demand shows a negative sign. Price elasticity is a relative amount as it is the ratio of two percentages, that is, the ratio percentage of change in quantity demanded and the percentage change in its price. Thus, the absolute value is to be considered and not the algebraic one. And the negative sign just reflects the inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded. Types of price elasticity. Greater the numerical value of price elasticity, greater is the demand responsiveness to price change. Similarly, smaller the numerical value of price elasticity, smaller the demand responsiveness to price change. Due to varying responsiveness of demand to change in price of a commodity, economists have categorized price elasticity into five types. They are elastic demand, inelastic demand, unitary demand, perfectly elastic demand, and perfectly inelastic demand. Elastic demand. When percentage change in quantity demanded is more than percentage change in its price, then such a demand is termed as elastic. Elastic demand is also termed as more elastic demand or relatively elastic demand. From the diagram, in the visual, one can see that QQ dash is greater than PP dash, which shows that change in demand is greater than change in price. Inelastic demand. When percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price, then such a demand is termed as inelastic demand. Inelastic demand is also termed as less elastic demand or relatively inelastic demand. In the diagram shown in the visual, QQ dash is less than PP dash, which shows that change in demand is less than change in price. Unitary elastic demand. When percentage change in quantity demanded is proportionate to or equal to the percentage change in price, then such a demand is termed as unitary elastic demand. In the diagram shown in the visual, QQ dash is equal to PP dash, that is, change in quantity demanded is equal to change in price. Perfectly elastic demand. When an insignificant or extremely small change in price causes an extraordinary larger change in the demand, then it is termed as perfectly elastic demand. Here, a slight rise in price renders the demand zero, or a slight fall in price raises the demand to infinity. It is a case of complete responsiveness. Perfectly inelastic demand. Irrespective of any change in price, if the quantity demanded remains constant, then such a demand is termed as perfectly inelastic demand. Thus, in this type of elasticity, change in price fails to bring about any change in the quantity demanded. It is also termed as zero elasticity and is a case of total unresponsiveness. The last two types are considered as extreme elasticities of demand. Measurements of price elasticity. There are four methods to measure price elasticity of demand. They are percentage or ratio method, total outlay or revenue method, point method or geometric method, arc or midpoint method. Percentage or ratio method. An accurate figure of price elasticity can be obtained by this method. It is also termed as ratio method, as price elasticity in this method is calculated by ratio of percentage change in demand and percentage change in price of a commodity. If Q is the quantity demanded and delta Q is the change in quantity demanded and P is price and delta P is the change in price, then symbolically price elasticity is presented as EP is equal to delta Q upon Q into P upon delta P, that is percentage change in quantity upon percentage change in price. Total outlay method. In this method, to find out whether demand is elastic or not, the total outlay or the total expenditure of the consumer is considered. Total outlay is equal to price into quantity purchased or sold. Unit elastic demand, when the total outlay remains constant irrespective of the change in price, then it is unit elastic demand. Relatively elastic demand. With the rise in price, if the total outlay falls and vice versa, then it is a relatively elastic demand. Relatively inelastic demand. With the rise in price, the total outlay rises, and with the fall in price, the total outlay falls. It is termed as relatively inelastic demand. The table given in the visual clears the total outlay method. Point method or geometric method. Under this method, geometrically price elasticity is calculated at any point on the demand curve. The method considers the inverse relationship between price and quantity demanded presented using a demand curve. The demand curve used for point estimation of price elasticity is a linear demand curve with its extreme points touching both the axes as shown in the visual. The elasticity at any point on the linear demand curve is calculated as the ratio of the lower segment of the curve below the given point to the upper segment of the curve above the given point. That is, point elasticity is equal to lower segment of the curve upon upper segment of the curve. In this method, if the ratio of lower segment to the upper segment is 1, then it is a unit elastic demand. At point B, BD dash upon BD is equal to 1. If the point of which the elasticity is to be calculated is towards the lower side of the curve, like point C, M, their elasticity is relatively less. And if the points like A and N, which are towards the upper side of the curve, their elasticity is relatively more. The diagram in the visual would make it more clear. ARP method or midpoint method. In case of large changes in price and quantity demanded, the ARG method is used to calculate price elasticity of demand. In this method, price elasticity of demand can be obtained by taking the average of original price and subsequent price, as well as average of original quantity and subsequent quantity as the basis of measurement of percentage change in price and quantity. This is clear from the diagram and formula presented in the visual. Income elasticity of demand. Just like price, the other determinants of demand like income, related goods too affect quantity demanded. The responsiveness of demand due to change in them is also measured as that of price. A direct relationship exists between level of consumer's income and the quantity demanded. Income elasticity of demand can be defined as the ratio percentage change in quantity demanded to the percentage change in income. Income elasticity can be measured by following formula. Income elasticity is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded upon percentage change in income. Symbolically, it is presented as EY is equal to percentage delta Q upon percentage delta Y, where delta Q is the change in quantity demanded and delta Y is change in income. Types of income elasticity. The effect of change in income on the quantity demanded vary from product to product, just as price. Accordingly, income elasticities are as follows. Unitary income elasticity greater than 1, income elasticity less than 1, zero income elasticity, and negative income elasticity. Unitary income elasticity of demand. When percentage change in quantity demanded is equal to percentage change in income, it is termed as unitary income elasticity. Symbolically, it is represented as EY is equal to percentage delta Q upon percentage delta Y is equal to 1. Income elasticity greater than 1. Demand is income elastic or income elasticity is greater than 1 if the percentage change in quantity is greater than percentage change in income. Symbolically, it is represented as EY is equal to percentage delta Q upon percentage delta Y greater than 1. Income elasticity less than 1. Demand is termed as income inelastic or less than 1 if the percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in income of the consumer. Symbolically, it can be represented as EY is equal to percentage delta Q upon percentage delta Y less than 1. Zero income elasticity. Sometimes, any change in the income does not affect the quantity demanded of a particular product at all. The demand for such a product is zero income elastic. Symbolically, it is represented as Ey is equal to percentage delta Q upon percentage delta Y is equal to 0. Negative income elasticity. When rise in income of a consumer actually reduces the demand of a particular product, then such a product is said to have a negative income elastic demand. Usually, inferior goods, that is given goods, are negatively income elastic. When consumers of such product have a rise in their income, they tend to purchase lesser and lesser of inferior goods and move towards superior goods. Symbolically, it is represented as Ey is equal to percentage delta y less than 0. Cross elasticity of demand. Having discussed the effect of price and income on the quantity demanded and the way to measure them, we now move to understand how price of related goods affect the demand of a particular good. Cross elasticity of demand measures the degree of responsiveness of demand of a commodity to the change in price of another related commodity, whether a substitute or a complementary good. Thus, cross elasticity of demand measures the extent to which the price of a substitute or a complementary good affects the demand of a particular good. Cross elasticity of demand between two goods A and B can be presented as cross elasticity AB is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded of A upon percentage change in price of B. Symbolically, it is presented as EAB is equal to delta QA upon QA divided by delta PB upon PB. Types of cross elasticities. From business people to planners, the concept of cross elasticity of demand is equally important as that of price and income elasticity. Following are the three types of cross elasticities: positive cross elasticity, negative cross elasticity, and zero cross elasticity. Positive cross elasticity of demand. Substitute goods reflect positive cross elasticity of demand. Positive cross elasticity of demand is the ratio of percentage increase in demand of A to percentage increase in price of B. Symbolically, it is presented as EAB is equal to percentage increase in demand of A upon percentage increase in price of B. Example: with the rise in price of coffee, the consumers of coffee find tea relatively cheaper and so shift to tea. Thus, with the rise in price of coffee, the demand of tea rises. Negative cross elasticity of demand. Complementary goods reflect negative cross elasticity of demand. Negative cross elasticity of demand is the ratio of percentage increase in demand of A to the percentage decrease in price of B. Symbolically, it is presented as EAB is equal to percentage increase in demand of A upon percentage decrease in price of B. Example: petrol and petrol cars are complementary goods. With rise in price of petrol, there is a fall in demand of petrol cars. Zero cross elasticity of demand. If two products are not at all related or zero relation exists between them, then these goods are said to have zero cross elasticity. Thus, when price of one product has no effect on the demand of another, then it is termed as zero cross elasticity. Example: price of cars and demand for books have no relation between them and so have zero cross elasticity of demand. Average revenue, marginal revenue, and elasticity of demand. Let us now discuss the relationship between average revenue, marginal revenue, and elasticity of demand. Firstly, we shall define the above concepts, which would then facilitate us in understanding the interrelationship between them. Total revenue. Total revenue is the product of total quantity sold and the price per unit. Average revenue. Average revenue is the per unit output sold. Marginal revenue. Marginal revenue is the addition in the total revenue by selling one additional unit of output. With the rise in quantity sold and fall in price, when total revenue rises, then it is elastic demand. With the rise in quantity sold and fall in price, when total revenue falls, then demand is inelastic. The relationship between AR, MR and elasticity ED is graphically presented in the visual and is explained as under. When marginal revenue is positive in the diagram, from the quantity 0 to 60, the TR, that is total revenue, is rising with fall in price in the diagram A. Thus, demand is elastic. When marginal revenue is negative at any quantity above 60, the TR, that is total revenue, decreases with the price fall. The demand here is inelastic. When MR is 0 and TR, that is total revenue, is maximum, elasticity is unitary at 60. Determinants of elasticity of demand constitute those factors which affect the elasticity of a product. The three main determinants are as follows: existence of substitute, length of time allowed for adjustment, share of the product in a consumer's budget. Existence of substitute. The number of substitutes and also their closeness affects the elasticity of demand. Larger and closer the substitutes available, more is the elasticity of demand and vice versa. The reason is, if price of a product having good substitutes rises, the consumer will reduce its consumption and shift to the substitutes. Thus, the demand of the original product falls. Reverse reaction would happen if the product has no or less close substitutes. Length of time allowed for adjustment. Longer the time allowed for adjustment to the change, more is the demand elasticity, and shorter the time allowed for adjustment, lesser is the demand elasticity. This can be explained as, when longer period is available for adjustment to the change in price of a commodity, the consumer has enough time to change either the pattern of consumption or the search for closer substitutes. This makes the demand for that product elastic. Similarly, shorter the time available for adjustment, lesser would be the elasticity. Share of the product in consumer's budget. It is also observed that price elasticity is directly related to the share of consumer's income spent on that product. Thus, milk takes a larger share of a housewife's kitchen budget as compared to salt, and so former is comparatively more elastic than the latter. Importance of elasticity of demand. The measurement of demand responsiveness is not only important to the businessmen but also for the policy makers. Using the elasticity theories, now the managers can decide whether to opt for a price rise or to go for buy one get two free to raise their revenues. Thus, concept of elasticity of demand guides the businessmen in deciding. The businessman in deciding price strategies, considering the type of product, income of consumer and price of related goods. Fiscal policy framers, while preparing budget or making any policy, always have to keep in mind how much the taxes or the subsidies are going to affect the demand or supply of goods and services. Necessities, luxuries, comforts, durables, perishable goods, etc., all have different elasticity, so would be differently affected by price cuts or hikes.